Cannabis plants need an adequate amount of water to thrive. Whether you're growing cannabis indoors or outdoors, the plant must get sufficient water to grow well. Knowing when to water your plants, and more importantly, knowing when not to water them, can be tricky. So the question is, how to know when to water a cannabis plant? Let's find out after the intro. Water is quite important for the internal processes in the plant as it provides hydrogen to aid the development of the plant. The quantity of water fed to the plant affects the growth rate. Too little water reduces the plant's growth rate, and too much could potentially clog up its roots, causing it to suffocate or even cause root rot that can severely harm or even kill the plant. How can you determine how much water your cannabis plants need? When it comes to watering cannabis plants, there are no defined rules because the amount of water required depends on its growing environment. Factors such as the size of the plant, the size of the container your plant is growing in, the canopy, the root size, and the temperature of the grow room. The amount of water should be just enough to keep your soil moist, but not wet. The plant will use more water if the environment is very hot. But you should never give a cannabis plant more water than it can absorb. In general, there are succeeding plant stages: germination, the seedling stage, the vegetative stage, and the flowering stage. Each stage has its own water requirements. How often should you water a seedling? Once a plant passes the germination stage and becomes a seedling, you will notice the plant developing more of the traditional cannabis fan leaves. It is best to water twice a day, but focus on frequency over volume during this stage. It is crucial that you use a substrate that drains well enough but still retains some water. Perlite can be a great addition to your soil to make it drain better. How often should you water cannabis plants during the vegetative stage? The vegetative stage typically starts within 3 to 16 weeks. You can be sure your plant is in the vegetative stage when your seedling develops at least 7 sets of pointed leaves. The vegetative stage of a cannabis plant's life cycle is crucial. Growers must ensure that their plants receive the proper amount of light, water, and nutrients during this time to meet their needs. Watering the plants daily is ideal if you're using small pots. If you're growing in large containers, consider watering your plants every 2 days. The rule of thumb is to only give as much water so that the soil stays moist for 24 to 36 hours. If it stays wet longer, your soil is either not draining well enough or you are watering too much. In both cases, stop watering until your soil is dry again. If the soil does not dry up within 4 days, your soil is most likely retaining too much water. Repotting and using perlite or switching over to a soil that retains less water might be necessary. How often should you water cannabis during the flowering stage? The flowering stage lasts about 8 to 11 weeks for most cannabis strains, though some sativa strains take even longer. It is best to water the plants every 2 to 3 days during this stage. And make sure not to water your plants more than usual to prevent overhydration, root rot, and stripping the soil's nutrients by flushing them out. Once you are close to harvesting your cannabis, at the end of the flowering stage, there's a process called flushing. Flushing is an important part of the cannabis growing process. Flushing the cannabis plants entails intentionally removing any nutrients from the soil with plain water. This is done to flush out the nutrients that have built up by the use of fertilizers. It is usually done about a week before harvest, at the end of a plant's flowering stage when buds are almost ready to be cut down. To learn more about cannabis flushing, you can read our blog post "How to Flush Cannabis" linked in the description box below. If you're not utilizing fertilizers or use very clean organic fertilizers, you don't need to flush your plants. Does water quality matter? Even if you get the watering process right, a low quality water source could slowly undo all of your hard work. Water quality definitely matters, and one factor in determining water quality is checking its pH level or potential hydrogen. The pH level measures the water's acidity and alkalinity and occurs on a scale of 0 most acidic to 14 most alkaline. If you want to find out more about the optimal pH for cannabis plants, consider watching our video "What is the best pH value for cannabis plants?" What are the most common watering issues? Many watering issues are actually soil issues, retaining too little or too much water. You should make sure to use adequate soil prior to growing, as changing it later is difficult and puts a lot of stress on the plants. Another common issue is overwatering. Cannabis requires a fairly decent amount of water, but it does not thrive in damp, soaking or soggy soil. This can occur when a plant is watered too many times in a short while or when too much water is used when watering. You have to make sure that whenever you're watering your plants, the water makes the soil wet but does not accumulate so much that it pools above the top layer of the soil. If your plant's leaves are drooping, then it's usually a sign of either over or underwatering. Underwatering can also become an issue since it can cause the minerals to build up, resulting in a nutrient lockout. Other signs of underfeeding nutrients are dry, papery, or yellowing leaves. Often growers think they have a hydration issue when it's actually a nutrient issue. We recommend reading our blog post "How to Know Which Nutrients Are Lacking in the Cannabis Plants," linked in the description below, to know more about this. Feel free to share your experience with us in the comments. If you want to dive deeper into this topic, you can head over to weed-smart.com and read the full article on this topic. Do you enjoy factual and informative cannabis content? If so, consider subscribing to this channel so you can watch and learn from our upcoming videos. If you want the YouTube algorithm to understand that you enjoyed watching this video, then leave a like and a comment. See you in the next video.